that breaks your heart. Whoa.
Music.
I listen to it all the time, actually.
Just hits on Goom Radio.
All right, we're hanging out with David Archuleta in the studio. What's good? Hello.
Hey.
Hi there.
How's life going, my friend?
Oh, it's going well. Life is good.
Life is
right?
good.
Yeah. I would imagine so.
Right? I gotta give you a big congratulations. Your album is dropping today. Seriously.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Yes.
What's going on through your mind right now?
Thank you.
What's going on?
I guess it's just kind of weird thinking about what everyone else might be thinking.
Right?
Wondering. It's like, what does everyone think of it? Who's buying it? Is anyone buying it? I don't know. But it's exciting. It's been a big, long, busy year of just trying to get this album created, and now it's done, and it's in stores, so it's crazy.
That must be crazy, though. Like, I'm, like, talking on the radio, I'm self-conscious. Do people actually listen to me? But having an album out, and then, like,
yeah.
You need to come through, you need to be that cool guy. Like,
are they judging me? I just said something really stupid.
Yeah.
Are they going to listen again?
I say dumb things all the time. I've just learned to embrace that. It's like, it's just...
Yeah, you can't...
Right?
You, you can't change who you are. You can say it, you can try and change it, but you are who you are.
Yeah, exactly.
But
yeah.
I like you, because you say you're not cool, which is cool to me. People who admit that they're not cool, in my book, are very cool.
Oh, thanks.
And I'm not going to lie, you look very cool. Your hairstyle is called a faux hawk, right? Is that the proper terminology?
I don't know. It might have fallen down into faux hawk.
It looks good.
Yeah.
I like it
a lot.
Thanks.
It's a very cool
I
hair.
I can't see it right now, so I don't know.
You want to hear a really weird fact?
Good.
The faux hawk was originated by that show, Phil the Future, on Disney Channel, starring Ricky Ullman. He's the first person who ever had a faux hawk.
Really?
Ricky Ullman, Phil the Future. Google
really?
It. Good show.
How'd you know?
I don't know. I Googled it.
Zach has a lot of time on his hands.
I have, yeah. I know awkward knowledge and random knowledge that no one would even waste their time in knowing, like the fact that Phil the Future was the first person to have a faux hawk on TV.
I thought it was like European. Oh, on TV.
On TV. He was like, you know, wake up and have like the first faux hawk.
Haven't faux hawks been around since like the 80s though or something?
I don't know. Maybe Google lied. Are you...
You're questioning my knowledge.
I'm getting really self-conscious right now. I feel naked and vulnerable.
People are judging you.
Oh, God.
No.
Well, speaking of being judged in the album, what do you care more about? Do you care, like, do you read the reviews from critics? Does that stuff get to you? I know it's obviously important what the fans think and people who are purchasing your music, but does it bother you, you know, if you read a review that may not be so favorable, or how do you take that?
I don't really read reviews. I don't know. I don't, because I know there are going to be negative things and positive things, and I don't, you know, I'm sure if I were to look, I'd come across both, and I don't know. I just don't think... I know that if I saw something negative, I would be like, ah.
Yeah.
So even if I did see the positive things, so it's like, you know, I don't want to read them.
Why is it that the negative things always resonate more than the positive things?
That's why you need to focus on the positive things and allow that to resonate.
Amen.
Because absolutely.
You know what's going to happen when you see the negative stuff. You know it's there. So,
yeah.
So it's just, I'm more interested in seeing what the people who are... buying the music and what they're thinking, you know, how they feel and what songs leave an impression on them and that kind of stuff. Because it's like, I already know how hard I worked on the album, and I already know there are a lot of things I still need to improve on, but I still want to see how the hard work paid off.
I like that.
See, I like that.
I would read the positive reviews because I'd feel so good about myself.
I don't know.
Right?
I think it's better not to read any of them because then you don't... If you read the positive ones, you don't want to get like... Too confident,
right?
And stuff. And too comfortable.
I think it's good leaving that mystery.
You just enlightened me. Now I'm going to change my whole lifestyle. Now I'm not going to read any reviews.
No.
Wow.
Zach spends all day on the internet googling himself.
You know how people Google me? It's just me. Okay, I sit around. I Google myself. Not really. That's sad.
Yeah.
You give yourself all your hits.
Yeah.
Do you spend a lot of time on Wikipedia?
I write my own Wikipedia all the time.
Oh,
I update
really?
It. No.
Do you Google yourself?
No.
No? Not at all?
No.
See,
if I was as big as you, I would probably Google myself just a few times. Just because people are saying really great things about you, so that would definitely help me out a little bit.
I don't know. I think it's better to read great things about other people. It's like,
wow.
Because if you read about other people, then it's like, man, I want to be more like them. You can't really do that if you're looking for someone. I want to be more like me. I don't know. But it's, you know, it gives you direction of where you want to take yourself.
You're freaking,
to improve.
You're freaking great.
Yeah.
This is I'm so enlightened right now.
We're learning. David Archuleta is teaching us. How not to be too into yourself. You care more about other people than yourself.
No.
Now tell me. I'm sorry. Want to continue?
Nothing better than... It's like when you care about other people, it makes you feel better.
It does.
So it
Absolutely.
Makes you feel like a better person, too. I don't know.
Wow.
Because you think less about yourself. It's interesting how that works. How the less you think about yourself, the better you feel.
Yeah.
I'm going to start doing this. I'm going to live my life a different
Dude,
way.
You just stop being so self-centered. All of us. We need to care more about other people.
This is beautiful right now. I think I might cry. Like You just flipped over a new leaf.
He cries at everything.
Oh, no.
I live on an emotional roller coaster. I cry. I don't know. Is that weird? Have you cried before?
Are you a crier?
I think everyone has cried sometime in their life, especially when they're little.
Thank you. I cry. I don't know.
No, people cry when they're happy, cry when they're sad, when they're laughing, for laughing too hard, you know?
I love crying from laughing. It's such a good feeling.
I don't. My cheeks hurt and it gets all like strenuous when you like laugh
you
really hard.
So many calories.
Open up your jaw. Open up your jaw more.
I'll laugh really loudly.
Here.
Actually, that feels better.
Oh my god. People. I gotta tell you, your tweets are so funny. I'm a follower of David Archie on Twitter.
Thanks.
People like your tweets. Telling you. I was nominated against you for a Twitter award, like this big shorty award. You won, but it was like for funny category, and you dominated every category. Every category. I don't know. People love your tweets.
But why? I don't know why. I was just like, you know, you just kind of tweet what's on your mind, and or like if something strikes your attention or something. It's just weird. Sometimes it's like, why do people... It's interesting to think that people actually follow you.
Right?
Isn't it creepy?
Say.
Yeah.
But it's like, but why? What am I saying that's significant? To make people want to go and see what I have to say.
I think that your Twitter is an extension of you. So people just want... People care about you. So even if you're just like, hey, check out my single. It's like, oh my god, David Archuleta is on Twitter. I love him so much. Somebody check out a single. You know what I mean?
Oh.
That's only what Shelly does.
Me.
No, I think it's awesome. Your tweets are funny and it shows you and it just shows like cool, grounded tweets. I'm a fan. I'm a fan of your tweets.
Thanks. What are grounded tweets?
I don't know. It's like not grounded.
Yes, Zach, enlighten us. What are grounded tweets?
You enlightened us. It is my time. Okay. My opinion when I look at someone's tweets, right, especially if like you're a celebrity, if it shows you and like what you do and like kind of funny and you're being yourself, it's not like every other tweet is like, buy my single, buy this, buy that. You know what I mean? It's like not promoting and there's not like a link after everything telling people what you want them to do. It shows you and I like it.
Oh, thanks. I feel like I might have been promoting a little bit this week just because I'm letting people know about, because there's like a bunch of new stuff and then the CD came out today and stuff like that.
Congratulations, dude. That's huge, the CD coming
thank
out.
You.
Yes.
Thanks. Yeah, it's exciting.
Is it creepy that I'm on your Twitter right now?
See, look, I feel like the ones lately have been promoted. I mean...
But that's okay. You gotta let people know what you're doing and what's going on.
I'm not judging you.
No, we're not judging you at all.
It's just because it's been a work week, so off... I feel
look,
dumb.
You find time to slip in a really nice quote. In family relationships, love is really spelled T-I-M-E. Taking time for each other is the key for harmony at home. I like that.
That is beautiful.
That's deep.
I just cried on the inside right now. You can't see it, but it's going on in the inside.
I feel like
a cheesy person right now.
No, you're showing yourself, and I like how you answer your fans. Do you try to tweet them as much as possible?
I have to be honest. I'm not good at keeping up with that, but I'm trying to get better at it. So I'm going to try and make an effort to respond more. And I guess people get disappointed when they don't know when I talk to the fans. So I'm going to, because there's sometimes where I just will start directly tweet at replying people. Mm-hmm. But a lot of people don't know. It's only the people who are looking at my page and seeing, I guess, what's going on.
Right.
So I guess I need to get better at saying, hey, I'm going to announce. I'm going to respond to some questions if you want to send some.
See, that's
so
cool.
I need to work on that.
Yes.
But I'm it's part of my plan of just getting better at tweeting this. So it's there. It's part of my plan.
This is freaking awesome.
Yeah, well, we're giving you positive reinforcement that we appreciate your tweets.
This is
thanks.
This is a no judgment film.
No.
I'm really
no judgment film.
Yeah, I'm planning on like getting
it makes
that,
me feel better.
Right? I'm gonna get it plastered on top of like the wall, like of the studio. So then you know how in football movies, every time someone walks out, they hit the wall. That's what we're gonna do. And we're gonna like bang on no judgment.
No judging.
All right? See?
Cool.
It's a great idea.
Yeah.
I'm chock full of ideas. It's just putting them into action where I suck.
I love the way your mind works.
So tell me, everything on the CD, tell me more about the CD. And you got your single, something about love, plus you got Elevator. I'm telling you, this song is so good.
Oh, thank you.
Oh my God.
Thanks.
I love this song.
Thanks.
Dude, it's so good.
I really like Elevator. It's, I mean, what's so funny about it is just, I wasn't even expecting it to go on the album.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just kind of like, it wasn't trying to be anything. When we wrote it, we wrote it really fast. And it was just like, it was just very satisfying. And but it wasn't really trying to be anything else. It was just what it was. And so I think that's why I like the song so much. And it's really fun to get to sing live. It's literally about a dream I had. So it's just a very kind of quirky song.
I'm telling you, it's so good. And it's like a different sound from Something About Love. I really like it.
Oh,
it's really good. So that's going to be your next single, right? Elevator?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wow, see?